Dear students, in this lecture, we shall try to understand what is wave. We shall find out the wave equation, and also we shall see some definitions related to waves. So now, what is wave? Any periodic disturbance in a medium or a space is known as wave. Now there are two kinds of waves in terms of the medium required or not required for propagation. One is mechanical wave. Here some material or medium is required for the disturbance to be propagated. Here the medium should be as such, the particles should be connected, or the particles should be in a position to exert force on the neighboring particles so that the disturbance is being communicated to the neighboring particles and the disturbance propagates. Another kind is non-mechanical wave. Before going into non-mechanical wave, examples of mechanical waves are sound waves. Air can be the medium for the propagation. Water waves. You all have seen ripples in water. The disturbance is being propagated through water. These can be two examples. Now, non-mechanical wave. Non-mechanical wave requires no material and there is some change in space. For example, electromagnetic waves. In electromagnetic waves, the electric field and the magnetic field, they change. The electric field takes one value and it goes to some other value, and those values are traced back and they are function of time. So the values of electric field and the magnetic field takes one particular value to another particular value. So these are the examples of non-mechanical wave. No material or medium is required for propagation. Example, an electromagnetic waves. Now there are some other categories of waves as well. According to the direction of the material movement and the direction of the propagation of the disturbance or the wave. Transverse and longitudinal waves. In this kind of wave, the material movement is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the disturbance or the wave. Now, example can be electromagnetic waves, periodic motion imparted to a string, etc. Now, longitudinal waves. In longitudinal wave, the material movement is parallel to the direction of the propagation of the disturbance. Example can be sound waves or a spring mass system. So these are some categories of waves. Now we shall try to find out the equation of wave. We shall see how the wave is propagating. We shall try to find out the traveling wave equation. Now suppose there is a string which is fixed to a bar, and there is a person who has held this string and who is snapping the string. So what will happen is that there will be a bump which will be formed like this. A bump will be formed and the bump will travel towards right with a particular constant velocity, which will be called the velocity of the wave. Like this. Now the bump has formed and it is traveling towards right. So after some time, it is here. And again after some time, the position of the bump is like this. So the bump is traveling towards right. This is the disturbance which is traveling towards right. This bump travels towards right with a constant velocity. And let that velocity be V. This V is called the velocity of the wave. Now, this is the displacement y and this is x, which is the position. Now the disturbance which is here at this time, in time t before, must have been somewhere there, and it has traveled a distance vt in time t. So the disturbance which is at this position must have been somewhere here, or it must have originated from here and come to here in time t, traveling a distance x equal to v t. Now at same instant of time, this disturbance at different positions are different. Also with change in time, this disturbance at same position is also different. So we can say that this displacement y must be a function of both the position and the time. So it must be a function of position as well as time. So we can write this displacement y of the disturbance as y as a function of x and t, both the position as well as the time t. Now the disturbance, suppose the time right now is t and the position be x. So at time t equal to 0, t equal to 0, the disturbance must have been in a position x minus vt. The position must have been x minus vt, as it would have originated at time t equal to 0 in position x minus vt. So same displacement will be there at this present time, at time t equal to t and position being x. So both the displacement must be same. Which displacements? The displacement at time t equal to t and position x, as well as the displacement at time t equal to 0 at the position x minus vt. So as this is so because the same displacement is carrying forward and coming to the position x in time t, traveling a distance vt. So we can write, since the both displacements are same, we can write f x t must be equal to f, this is y equal to f x t must be equal to f. Here in place of x we will have x minus vt, and in place of t we must have 0. So we will have to find an equation which will satisfy this fact that the value of the position at position x and x minus vt and time t and time t equal to 0 must be same. So we can have this equation having a combination of x and t. In the equation we must have x and t and some combination of x and t. So let us try one or two combinations and let us see if this condition is being satisfied or not. So let us take a very simple combination of x and t. Let y equal to x plus vt. Let us try with this combination. So what is our condition? At the displacement at x at time t using this equation is y equal to x plus vt, and the displacement at time t equal to 0 and position x minus vt will be y equal to, in place of x you will write x minus vt, x minus vt plus v, and time is 0. So y in this case is equal to x minus vt. So from here you can see that here the value of displacement is x plus vt, and here the value of displacement is x minus vt. So here it is x plus vt and here it is x minus vt. So this combination is not satisfying our condition, this condition. So we will have to look for some other equation which will have both x and t. So let us try with some other combination, simple combination. In place of plus we can write minus. So if we try with x, y equal to x minus vt. So at time t equal to t and value of position being x, this is equal to y equal to x minus vt, and at position x minus vt and time t equal to 0, y equal to x minus vt and minus v, and now what is the time? Time is 0. So we put 0 here, and what is our equation? Y equal to x minus vt. So from here you can see that our condition is being satisfied. That is, the value of displacement at the position x and time t is same as the value of the displacement which is at position x minus vt at time t equal to 0. So this is the combination, this is the only combination which we can use for writing the wave equation. We can have any combination. So we have The combination like this, x minus v t. So since the motion is being repeated periodic, so we can take a very simple combination of this one having x minus v t. We can take the combination having sin, that is sin x minus v t. Now there is some difficulty with this one, because we know that the argument of sin must be dimensionless, it shouldn't have any dimension. And now here we have got some dimension, it is the dimension of what? Dimension of length. So we have to do something to make this one dimensionless. So what we can do? We can multiply it with some constant k having the dimension of one by length. So we can multiply it, sin k x minus v t. So this has made this one, this argument dimensionless. But there is again some problem. What is that? The left hand side is y, and y is displacement, and that is having a dimension of length. So dimensionally we have to make this equation correct. So what we can do? We will equate it and we will again multiply it with another constant a having dimension of what? Length. Because this is having dimension of length, so we will multiply with dimension which is having a dimension of length. So this is equal to y equal to a sin k x minus v t. We can consider it as the equation of wave which is traveling towards the positive x direction. This is the equation of wave traveling towards the positive x direction. And if you have to find the equation of the wave traveling towards the negative x direction, it will simply have in place of minus a, it will be plus, that is y equal to a sin k x plus v. This is the equation of wave traveling towards negative x dash. So we can write the equation of wave as y equal to a sin k x minus v t, and this is equal to a sin k x minus k v t, and we write it as a y equal to a sin kx minus omega t. K is called the wave number. Here omega is the angular frequency. Y
What is the value of omega from here? Omega equal to A B. And A, this A is called the amplitude. Now we shall see some definitions related to this wave. Phase. In wave, there are points which are having the same displacement, same velocity, that is the particle velocity, and the same direction of the particle velocity. These points are known as phase. Having points having same phase. The points in wave having same displacement, same velocity, and same direction of velocity. Are said to be in same phase, or are said to be in phase. Another thing is wave. Now at fixed time, when we have fixed the time, the points where the motion is repeated, that is the minimum distance between those points where the motion is repeated, is known as wave. At a fixed time, the minimum distance between two points in where the motion is repeated . That is, these two points have a same displacement same velocity and same direction of velocity. Is known as wave. Is known as generally we denote wavelength by lambda. Now, only students will be in units of length.
Now let us try to understand what is a wavelength. Here, the displacement is, as already mentioned, is a function of the position x and time t. Here we can see a wave, a sine wave to be precise, going towards the positive x direction. Let this be displacement axis, the y axis, and from the mean position, let this be the position or the x axis. Here we can see a particle is vibrating like this, it is going up, reaching the maximum point of displacement in the positive y direction. This is the maximum amplitude in the positive y direction. And again, it is coming back in the mean position, and again, it is going down further, reaching the maximum point of displacement in the y direction, in the negative axis. We have already seen the definition of wavelength, that is, the minimum distance between two points having the same displacement, same velocity and same direction of velocity at a fixed time. In real life, we cannot fix time, but in this video we can freeze the time by stopping this like this. Now, let's suppose we have got this point and this point. These two points have a displacement like this. This is the displacement, and they are having the same displacement. These two points having the same displacement. And here the velocity as well as the direction of the velocity are also same. In this point, the particle is just coming down. Here also the particle is just coming down. So the distance between these two points, which is the minimum distance wherein between these two points having the same displacement, same velocity and same direction of velocity. So this is called the wavelength lambda. Now, look at this point and also this point. These two are also having the same displacement, same velocity and same direction of velocity. But this is not the minimum distance. The minimum distance between two points is this much. Here, the distance between this and this will be twice the wavelength. Twice the wavelength, and this is the wavelength, distance between this point here and this point here. There can be numerous points where the displacement, the velocity and the direction of velocity are same, and the minimum distance between these two points will be the wavelength. It is a point here and a point here. So this is the displacement. You can see displacement is same between at these two points, and the velocity as well as the direction of velocity is also same. So the distance between these two points is the wavelength. Two points can be like this also, one point here, one point here. Is the displacement, they are same and velocity and the direction of velocity is also same. So the distance between these two points is the wavelength. The points can be like this, and suppose here and here. This is the displacement. See, displacement at both these points are same. Direction of velocity and the velocity are also same. So, this point, this minimum distance between this point is our wavelength. So, this is how we try to understand what is a wavelength.
Now, as already defined, the minimum distance in which the disturbance, the velocity, the displacement, the velocity and the direction of velocity will be same is known as the wavelength. So, this is the equation of the wave. This gives the displacement y equal to a sin a minus omega t. And now, what is the particle velocity? We have to differentiate this with respect to time to get the particle velocity. Let us give the symbol as u for the particle velocity. And if you differentiate this with respect to time, that is ty by dt, and this is equal to minus a omega cos kx minus omega t. Now we have said at x and at distance x plus lambda, the value of this displacement must be same. And similar is the case for this particle velocity. At x and also at x plus lambda, the value of this velocity must be same. So, y at a sin ax minus omega t must be equal to a sin kx plus lambda minus omega t. So the change in the angle is calculated as kx plus lambda minus omega t minus kx minus omega t. This is the change in the angle. What is that? Kx plus a lambda minus omega t minus kx plus omega t. This answers are and we are dealt with k lambda. So this is the change in the angle. For the argument. Now, same for the particle velocity, u at kx minus omega t should be equal to minus k omega cos kx plus lambda minus omega
t. So what is the change here?
Negative.
Yes. Then x less lambda minus omega minus x minus omega t, and this is again equal to a lambda. So for the minimum change in angle, when the value of sine and cos remains same or repeats itself, is 2 pi. So in both the cases the change is k lambda, and since the minimum change of the angle should be equal to 2 pi, so we can write k lambda is equal to 2 pi, or from here we can write k equal to 2 pi by lambda. So this is the value of our wave number. Wave number k is given by 2 pi by lambda. Now for fixed x, that is if we fix the position, then the suppose the motion repeats itself after an interval of time capital T, then at fixed position x and the interval of time capital T, the motion repeats itself. So we have 2 pi by lambda. So again, the displacement at time t equal to small t and time t equal to t plus capital T should be same, and also the particle velocity at time t equal to small t and t equal to small t plus capital T should be same. So let us write the equation. Displacement equal to a sine kx minus omega t should be equal to a sine kx minus omega t plus t. And so here again the change in the angle is omega t, and for the velocity, that is particle velocity u, this must be equal to minus a omega cos x minus omega t, so it is equal to a minus a omega cos x minus omega t plus t. Again, the change in angle is equal to omega t. Kx minus omega t plus t minus this one will give this omega t. The magnitude is omega t. So again, the minimum angle for which the value of sine and cos repeats itself should be equal to how much? Should be equal to 2 pi. Omega t should be equal to 2 pi. Therefore, omega or the angular frequency is equal to 2 pi by t, and t equal to 2 pi by omega. Wrong now. T equal to 2 pi by lambda, omega equal to 2 pi by t. Now we define another quantity called frequency, and this is given by 1 by t. And what is t? T is the time period. Is that interval of time after which the motion is being repeated at certain value of the position. So this is frequency, and this is equal to 1 by t. That is number of oscillations in 1 second. So its unit is second minus 1, and it's also called hertz. And it's written as Hz. So we can have some other relations as well. That is, omega we have found out as equal to A V. So omega is equal to 2 pi by t. And this is equal to 2 pi by lambda into v, or we can write lambda equal to v t. So we have lambda equal to v t, and also lambda is equal to v by frequency nu, because nu is equal to 1 by t. So t is equal to 1 by nu. Therefore we have this relation lambda nu equal to v. So these are some of the definitions related with the wave. Also, the wave equation is like this: y equal to a sine k minus omega t. So we can choose the value of x and t for certain value of the displacement according to our convenience. That is, we can take x equal to 0, t equal to 0 according to our convenience. Here, at x equal to 0 and t
equal to 0, what is the value of this displacement? This is y equal to 0. And what is particle velocity? Particle velocity is u, that is equal to minus a omega cos h minus omega t, left x equal to 0 and equal to 0, u is equal to minus a omega. So we have chosen our x equal to 0 and t equal to 0 in such a way that displacement y equal to 0 and the value of u is equal to minus a omega, that is, it is negative. That is, the particle is at the mean position and it is just going down. As it is negative, so it is at the mean position and it is just going down. So we can have the value of y in such a way that it gives the maximum displacement for x equal to 0 and t equal to 0. For that, we can write this equation as y equal to a sine x minus omega t plus y by 2. Then the particle velocity u will be equal to minus a omega cos h minus omega t plus y by 2. So at x equal to 0 and t equal to 0, y equal to a, because sine pi by 2 is 1, and the velocity is u equal to 0. So in this case, the particle has got the maximum displacement, that is, it is at the top, and as the particle velocity is 0, it means it has just started to come down. It has reached the top and started coming down. We can also have some value of y which is equal to 0 and the particle is going up. That is, velocity is positive and the particle is at the mean position. For that, we have to write this equation as y equal to a sine h minus omega t plus pi. For that, we have u equal to dy by dt equal to minus a omega cos h minus omega t plus pi. So at x equal to 0 and t equal to 0, what we have? Y equal to 0 and u equal to minus a omega and minus 1. Cos pi is minus 1. So this is minus minus plus, this is equal to a omega, u equal to a omega. So if you take the equation like this, the particle is having mean position, that is y equal to 0, and the velocity of particle is, as you can see from here, is positive, that is, the particle is at the mean position and it is going up. So whatever we want at x equal to 0 and t equal to 0, we can have it according to our own convenience. In general, we write this equation as y equal to a sine x minus omega t plus delta, where this delta is a constant which is called
phase constant. We can choose this value of delta according to our convenience, but it should remain constant throughout the motion. So in general, this is the equation of a traveling or its progressive wave. So today we'll stop here, and what we have learned today is we have discussed what is wave. We have categorized wave into mechanical wave, non-mechanical wave, transverse wave, longitudinal wave. Also, we have found out the wave equation, which was in the form of like this, A sin kx minus omega t, which is actually called a sine wave. And afterwards, we have generalized this wave equation as y equal to A sin kx minus omega t plus the phase constant, which is the general equation. Also, we have defined what is phase, we have defined what is wavelength, we have defined what is wave number, we have defined what is omega, what is frequency, and in general we have seen all these aspects of wave.